Okay, this is a brief overview of the data set that's available for Lab 2 for the Spring 2018 Applications in GIS for Disease Ecology class. Lab 2 consists of a polygon data set of the districts of Ghana, illustrated here in black outlines with no fill. And these green dots, which are a make-believe or a mock cattle outbreak with the following data attributes. If we open the table, you can see we have a total population for that point in space. We have the number of cases in week 2. We have the number of cases in week 1, week 2, and the number of deaths. Within the lab, you're going to be calculating some prevalence and cumulative incidence rates. You're going to be calculating the case fatality rate, and you're going to be mapping that. You're also going to be doing some point and polygon or spatial joins in this lab so that we can practice or learn the skills to map our point distributions like we reviewed in the last lecture on Monday, January 22nd, and want to be able to make sure that the class is comfortable doing coral pleth maps and how we generate those from a point data set and a polygon data set. So those will be the data sets that you'll use in Lab 2, and those prevalence and incidence rates are described in the lab write-up. What I want to show you now is just a refresher on how to do a point and polygon count using ArcMap. And in this case, we're going to use the spatial join tool to join the attributes from these individual point events to the larger polygons. So to do that, we're going to right-click on Ghana Admin 2. This is our polygon file. And we're going to navigate to the joins and relate and join. We're going to then join from another layer based on spatial location, also known as a spatial join. And I'm working remotely to put this video together, so it may be a bit slow. So Cow Weekly, that's the name of my point file. And what we want to do for a point in polygon is we want to summarize or summate all of the case data. So the total population and each, the week 1, the week 2, and the deaths, so that we can know for any given polygon how many of all of those things happen. So we're going to select each polygon will be given a summary of the numeric attributes of the points that fall inside and a count field showing how many points. So that's our direct point in polygon. And we'll receive the summation of each of the points for each polygon. And then we can save that. So I'm going to call this Ghana Admin to PNP for now, just for the purposes of illustration. Maybe asked to name it differently in the lab. And again, I'm working from a laptop across the network on wireless, so that's part of the slow process here. This should be much faster on your machines using either UF apps or working to your local directory. Okay, so that spatial join is running now. We can see here it says working spatial joining. And again, the purpose here is to aggregate the information about all of those point events for each polygon. So, for example, if we had 5 points inside of one polygon, we're going to summate all of the cases in week 1, all of the cases in week 2, all of the total population, and all of the deaths in that individual district or polygon with those data coming from those 5 individual points. So if I open the attribute table of my completed join process here, You can see I've maintained, or the process has maintained, all of the original information contained in the polygon, so information about name and so forth. And then as we scroll over, we see the following. We see that we get the total count, that's the count of points. We see that we get the sum total underscore, that was our total population. We get the sum of week one, the sum of week two, and the sum of deaths. And notice there are a number of these that are empty. Those are simply the polygons that don't have any cases whatsoever. For example, here in the central western provinces that I'm highlighting with the mouse, districts, excuse me. Okay, so we've tallied up our individual cases now. We can see that across the country, we have maybe a third or so of the polygons have data in them, and we can now go on and analyze those individual districts at the aggregate level. So as one quick example here, I'm going to set our quantities to graduated color. It's a choropleth map, so I'm going to use graduated color. I'm going to select for this example the deaths. And by default, it's going to do five classes of natural breaks. I'm just going to accept that for the moment and apply that. And now we can see our distribution as a choropleth map. So for lab two, you'll be performing this spatial join, and you'll be performing a series of calculations on each of the attributes in the spatial join and the attributes in the individual point file that we have here. Good luck, and keep the questions coming online.